Welcome to Skyrim for Seniors. Here we are outside Carth Wayston, out in the Reach, and we're here because we are going to deliver Garrel's sword. Garrel is a orc smith that we met up in one of the smith outposts where we got the sword master's or the forge master's fingers, and we met her and she created this sword to give to her daughter who had left to go out on her own. Her daughter's name is Lash. So here we are approaching Carth Wayston.
I want you to sell swords out of my mind.
Watch your tongue, native. We'll leave when we're sure there's no Forsworn here.
Oh, and when would that be, I wonder? When I sell my land to the Silverbloods?
The Silverbloods have made you a very generous offer for this pile of dirt. I suggest you take it.
I work in the mines. I hunt. Everything else I do is my business.
Your mother, Garrel, wants you to have this sword.
So that's it, then. Don't come back. Thank you. Here. You honored my mother's task and should be rewarded. Now, I need to be alone.
Are all the orc strongholds guarded?
The strongholds keep to themselves. Skyrim hasn't always been kind to the orcs. For an outsider like you to be accepted, an orc would have to make you bloodkin and send word to the chiefs. Trust like that is not freely given. All right, then.
Okay, so...
I'm one of the few native sons of the Reach that owns land. It doesn't make me very popular.
What you beating on your house for? Never mind. Trouble with the mine?
Robbery is what it is. The Silverbloods are trying to muscle in on my land. Forsworn attack the mines, and suddenly all these sellswords show up to help. They won't let anyone work until I sell it off.
What if I convince them to leave?
You can try, but I'd keep your sword arm ready if things get ugly. Good day.
All right. Let's go see what if we can convince them to leave. Apparently, convincing them to leave in a box is good enough. No Nordic carved armor. That is good money. Oh my, something got in my nose. Ooh. I think something drifted in. What is that? Oh. Some sort of. Oh, there's some garlic. Now this mine. Yes, it's a silver mine. So, Karth Waston. Actually, a nice little location to have identified. Out here in the Reach, there's a number of things we're going to do out here in the Reach, and Karth Waston is a good place to start some of them. Now there's some more silver, we just have to find it. Gold lockpick, hide armor, fur bracers. The rest of that's. And iron shield, gold, fur armor, orcish sword. Okay, we'll take that. Ooh, we got a couple of helmets, they're usually pretty good money. But not iron boots and whatnot. Oh, look like we have a couple choices. Let's go left. Right. Alright, so we've given Lash her sword. Let's see, we'll have some more. Items to get out of the inventory. Guess we just start at the top and work our way down. I think the next item was Red Eagle sword, I think. Silver is predominant up here in the Reach. Once we go into Markarth, there'll be much talk about silver. And they have a very confusing statement. I'm not going to bother to try to quote it because I'll just get it backwards or get it wrong. I'll wait till they quote it to me. Wow, another one. Whew. Lots of silver. And as I've said before, I'm well aware that I could equip pickaxe, much like you, well, exactly the same as you equip a sword or a war axe. And then you can bash the ore vein as though you were attacking an enemy. And you can save yourself all of 4 or 5 seconds. And I just don't care. I'm well aware of all of that. Actually, I put an amazing amount of thought into why anyone cares. More thought than it deserves, I think. But I did put a lot of thought into it as to why anyone would care. About saving a few seconds. I think maybe I came up with a reason. Legitimate reason. If you were young, oh, I like those shovels. You might well. For example, if you were still in high school, let's say, or even younger, your time to play a game would be limited, and you would only be able to play in the evening or the afternoon, late afternoon, evening. Let's go up here and chat with this fellow. Tell him his.
If the Forsworn aren't attacking my town, the Nords are trying to force me off it.
Those sellsores won't be a problem now, Mr. Anathox.
That won't be the last we hear from the Silverbloods. But at least we can get back to work.
Yes, sir, you can.
Thank you. You've done a good thing for me and my workers. Here, this is for you.
Well, thank you, sir. 800 gold. I appreciate it.
Farewell.
Now there's another mine. Oh, there you go. I guess you guys are going to work now. Okay.
May your weapons be sharp and your prey fresh.
Thank you, Lash. I appreciate the blessing. See what we have in here. Been a long time since I've been in this mine. As I said, the last game I played, I was at about hour 680 in the game when I quit to switch over to start a new game. And when you play for a very long time, at least the way I play, eventually you stop coming into mines and you just, or at least as I said, the way I play, and I start buying all the resources that I need. Wow. I remember that this mine doesn't have much, but I thought it had more than this. Wow, this is sort of pitiful. The this it? One pitiful vein? Okay. Not well cared for either, is it? Just looks to be a mess in here. We'd already been down here, hadn't we? It's not. Oh, there's another of my favorite shovels, and there's another. Well, I suppose it doesn't make enough money to be well cared for. I guess that's the Red Eagle's Fury. That's the item. Ooh, but we're at 225 carry weight, so we have to do something about that before we So we shall. This is a Tusell barrel. Orcish dagger, orcish sword, steel war axe. Forsworn armor, forsworn boots, fur, hide, leather bracers. Wrong button. I suppose 37, we can carry around a couple of gems and a petty soul gem. We'll worry about those next when they get up a little bit and wait. All right, now. Unlock the secret of Red Eagle's tomb. And Rebels Karn. That would explain why I identified that, wouldn't it? Ta-da. I know. Mushrooms. Door open right there. Pretty cool, huh? Oh, you just know that there are going to be things that are going to... come out and try to kill me. The only question... is how far do I walk before they pop up? That is the only question. What, you're gonna make me go up these stairs? Did. How about that? I didn't expect that. Although it usually works, but not always. Excellent. Excellent. Personally, I always ignore the minions if I can and go for the big guy. That doesn't always work. Sometimes you have to kill the minions. Bone meal, gold, honed ancient Nord greatsword of burning. Good grief. Now there were four of these. The goodies. Okay. We have a couple of soul gems. Small amount of gold. Dwarven greatsword. No reason to take that. I can make it. I I don't know what I picked up there. Gold ruby, speltone, a bound sword, silver, hide boots. Oh, for heaven's sakes. There's not much in there, is there? Skull. All right. I'll take it. Just not that much here. Although there's a bunch of skulls laying around. An amazing amount of skulls laying around. Well, that is an interesting face. That's a face you see in Skyrim. I don't know whose face it is. Perhaps I'm supposed to know. But I don't. Red Eagle's Bane. Now, okay, so it's no longer stuck in my inventory. Okay, very good. And so I can put it in there, and I can take it out, and I can put it in, I can take it out. Well, I'm going to take it out, and I'm going to go put it in my collection. And if for some reason I want to open that place up again, I'll just go get it again. Gold. I don't want iron stuff. And remember, there's all kinds of mushrooms in here. Anything stuck there? Ah, fresh meat. Yes, that's the fresh meat that's stuck there because of the dog thing. That's because of that thing in Falkreath. That's Alright, so Red Eagle's Bane is a unique weapon. And I believe we decided we put unique weapons right here. Now, I don't like those crossbows being there. What I want to put there is ancient Nord stuff. I don't know where I want to put those crossbows. How about in here? And now I've got that down right. That's it. Arrows, pickaxe, and Zephyr. That's where that should be. Okay. And apparel. I've got nothing but the apparel I'm wearing. Potions. I'm still collecting potions. And I will be for some time. Books. Spell Tome. Bound Sword. Okay. Skulls. Well on our way to collecting 100 skulls. Yes, that's what I'm after collecting, in case you're wondering. 100 of each of those miscellaneous items. There's a ton of miscellaneous items. And remember, in my way of playing the game, and in my philosophy, that's how you play Skyrim, is you make up your own game. Now you may wonder why I'm not bothering to sleep, and it's because it doesn't do you any good. Once you're wearing two
about you and your honeyed words.
Okay. I think this is the right road. If it's not, we'll figure it out fairly quickly. But what I'm doing is I'm trying to locate someplace before I start a quest. Because of how irritating it is to locate it inside the quest. It's just exceedingly irritating. Well, I find it exceedingly irritating. And I'd rather do it like this, and I think this is the right road. And so I'm going to spend the last few minutes of this session Yes, it is the right road. I now recognize it. And there we are, very quickly, much faster than I expected. Hamar's Shame. Okay. Now we can go back to Falkreath. And we'll end this session here in Falkreath.